We wait for a solar storm as an old friend rotates into the Earth's strike zone, and the solar flux dips even lower. Those stories and more in the news this week. Space weather this week has gotten very exciting. We have a large coronal hole that has rotated into the Earth's strike zone, and we're waiting for some fast wind from it now. And if this hole looks familiar, it should. This thing has rotated around at least 4 times, and the last 2 times it's actually bumped us to some decent storm levels. Back in September, it bumped us up to a G2 storm level, but it had a little extra oomph from an active region that was kind of right in the middle of it. Then in October, when it rotated back around, it bumped us to storm levels again. This time the active region was gone, but the storm levels lasted longer than before. And now this time, the region looks very similar to the way it did back in October. So we are expecting something that's close to storm levels. We might see aurora at mid-latitudes for a short while, and then expect effects to kind of linger at high latitudes for a little bit. But that's not the only story. We also, if you notice, it's completely spotless on the Earth-facing disk, and that means solar flux has tanked. We're down into the near mid-60s right now, and amateur radio propagation is suffering. Luckily, there's a little bit more brightness on the sun's backside, so hopefully in about a week we'll kind of pump up a little bit. Doubt we'll get back to marginal levels for radio propagation, but at least it's a little bit more than what we've got now. Switching to your M-flare threat meter, you can see we are flatlined when it comes to the X-ray flux, and therefore by proxy the solar flux is low. It's been low for quite some time, as a matter of fact. We're well below the B floor, absolutely nothing going on, no flares, no pops, nothing. This is why the solar flux is sitting in near the mid-60s. This means poor radio propagation for you emergency responders and shortwave radio, as well as amateur radio operators. And you're just going to have to continue to deal with this easily over the next week. This is what a solar minimum sun looks like, folks. We might get a little bit of a reprieve as some more bright areas rotate into Earth view off the sun's backside, but as of yet, we're not seeing any new active regions. Switching to your solar storm conditions, you can see we've actually been hovering around quiet to unsettled conditions easily for the last couple weeks in October. As a matter of fact, the last time we actually hit storm levels was mid-October, and that was even just for a short while. But since then, we've just kind of been bouncing around in the green, which has brought some nice aurora here and there to high latitudes, but nothing at mid-latitudes, not even for quite some time. But all of this is going to change as that fast wind from that coronal hole that's in the Earth strike zone right now hits us. We should be bumping up to active conditions, possibly even storm conditions here over the next day, and those conditions might even linger for a few days before things begin to quiet down. So we're all in hurry up and wait mode. So what else does our sun have in store for us this week? Well, this is Stereo A. It's our backside monitor. You can see here's Earth, here's the sun, and here's Stereo A staring at the sun from behind. And what you see on the backside is, well, not that much activity. It is a solar minimum sun, so we can't expect all that much. But we do see a dark region in the middle of Stereo's view. That is a remnant coronal hole, and that will be rotating Earthside here in about a week. It also will be rotating possibly into the Earth strike zone in a little over 2 weeks, and it will send us some fast wind, might bump us up to active conditions. I don't know if we'll make storm conditions from this one, but it could give us a little bit more aurora chances, especially for those of you at high latitudes. Now, also what you do notice is that rotating into Stereo's view are some bright regions. They're not really active regions, but it is kind of upping the brightness a bit. This is the reprieve that we've been looking for the solar flux. When these rotate Earthside in about a week or so, then we might get a little bit of a reprieve to bump us back up into the high 60s for solar flux and maybe hover around that marginal level for radio propagation. Switching to your solar storm conditions and aurora possibilities over the coming week, we are anticipating the fast wind from that coronal hole that has rotated into the Earth's strike zone. In fact, that fast wind is actually a little bit late. We should have been hit by it already. So that may indicate that the wind may not be quite as fast as we had hoped, but we're still expecting storm levels from this. At high latitudes, NOAA is expecting at least minor storm conditions and possibly major storm conditions. As a matter of fact, about a 45% chance of a major storm. At mid-latitudes, we're only expecting active conditions with about a 20% chance of a minor storm, and these conditions should linger into the early next week. In fact, at high latitudes, they could even linger through middle of next week. So your aurora photographers, be sure to keep your batteries charged, because these solar storms are coming fewer and further between. Now, you amateur radio operators, well, it's going to be a little bit of an issue for you guys on Earth's night side over the next few days, but then things should quiet down reasonably quickly and you should be able to get back to doing some DX. Switching to your solar flare and particle radiation storm outlook over the coming week, everything is still in the green when it comes to solar flares. We have a spotless sun right now, which means no risk for radio blackouts, but it also means we are back in the 60s. As a matter of fact, we're almost in the mid-60s for solar flux. Now, this should make GPS users very happy. Your reception, especially at dayside and at low latitudes, should look really good right now, but amateur radio and shortwave radio responders, right now radio propagation is in the dumper. We are going to be sitting at these low levels easily for the next week before we get any kind of reprieve and any kind of boost to the solar flux. So just got to kind of tough it out. You might get a little bit of a boost to radio propagation with this solar storm, especially as it begins to die down. But then on the day side, it's going to go back to poor. So you just got to tough it out. It is solar minimum, and, you know, that's just the way things are right now. Now, also because it's solar minimum, we do have a moderate radiation risk for frequent flyers, and this includes air crew who fly at over 800 hours annually and fly at high latitudes and high altitudes. You need to take this into consideration in your flight plans because your risk is moderate. And this does include you prenatal passengers. So the space weather this week has gotten very exciting. We have an old friend of a coronal hole that has rotated into the Earth's strike zone, and we are waiting on pins and needles for it to send us some fast wind. It's kind of late, so we're kind of going, what's taking so long? Anyway, you aurora photographers, especially at high latitudes, we could easily bump up to storm levels here over the next day or so. So stay on your toes, because this could be the best solar storm chance we have maybe for the next month. Now, you amateur radio operators and emergency responders and shortwave responders, well, the solar flux does not look very good for you right now. We are at poor levels for radio propagation, and although there is a reprieve coming, it's probably going to be another week before we see the brightness rotate Earthside. So just kind of hang in there and hope that the storm helps just a little bit with radio propagation. Now, you GPS users, on the other hand, well, you guys should be loving life. You should have some decent reception on Earth's dayside, and as far as the night side goes, well, as long as you stay away from the dawn dust terminators and away from aurora during that solar storm, your GPS reception should be top-notch. I'm Tamitha Scove. Thank you for watching.